was really a great birthday, and you guys are a part of that. Thank you so much. Like, every single comment, I try to get back to everybody, but I have not yet, but I will. So this is oh god, my bra's showing. It's still showing. This is totally catfish. These are not my real boobs, guys. This is called a Victoria's Secret bombshell. But period. So these are also from Fashion Nova. But this I got brand new at Goodwill. It still had the tags on it, but it is from Fashion Nova. I showed you guys it in a different video. I don't know when you'll see that video, but I wanted to upload something recent because you guys know I do like pre-recorded videos, and then they upload like weeks or months later. Like, I think I did my what I got for Christmas video in like March. So I wanted to just the video that I was gonna upload tomorrow, I'm just gonna upload this instead, because yeah, my birthday today is, what is today? August 15th. It is my best friend's birthday. Duh, Samantha. I'm trying to like, oh fuck, I don't know, bro, I'm so annoying. Hold on, I need to think.
Okay guys, I remember, it was just my timeline was getting messed up because I worked, like, I was technically at work at midnight on my birthday, and I stayed till like 1 in the morning because there was intakes and they all spoke only Creole, solo Creole. Usually all of the Haitian kids that we get most likely speak some Spanish or a little bit. These kids knew nothing. They didn't know what is your name. They didn't know anything. It was so sad. Let me not start off depressing, but like, y'all know I gotta, let me put this on, period. Look at this. Birthday girl, it's sparkly. My friend gave it to me to wear at my birthday dinner. But I'm just in a good fucking mood. And we love this for me. But yeah, I guess I'm doing soft spoken. I just ripped a shit ton of my hair out. What the fuck? Focus, Samantha, focus. Oh, should I whisper? I don't know. So basically, it was just like the saddest intake I ever did before. Like, when I got in my car, I was bawling the entire way home. It was just super sad because I've never seen in the whole, what, 13 months I've worked here, I've never seen people come and not have any papers, not even a phone number written down on a little piece of paper, like shoved in their pocket or their shoe or something. Like, they had nothing. They didn't even have, like, usually at the border they give the kids like a bag of like snacks and like a fidget spinner and like a couple pairs of clothes. But they literally came with clothes, just what they had on. That's all they had. That's all they had. That was crazy to me. No papers whatsoever. So basically, it's going to be really hard for the case managers. Some of them did not even know the phone numbers of their family back in Haiti. Nor anyone here barely knew their names. It was just really, really crazy and sad. And the part that made me cry when I left was that when I was doing paperwork, first of all, I've been depressed, like, for the past 2 days because my favorite kid fucking left. He's Haitian. He fucking left. He was there for, like, fucking 4 months. My heart is, like, broken. But, what the fuck was I saying? Oh, yeah, I woke him up in the middle of the night to come help me translate because, like, hello, I don't know how the fuck. Like, if I were to call a translation line, that would have taken fucking, like, 12 hours. There were 6 fucking kids to do. So, anyway, we were doing them, and the one kid, he didn't know how to write his name, and he was 17, guys. He was 17, and he didn't know how to write his name. My favorite kid, he was sitting across from me, because he's 17 also. He just looked at me, and, like, the whole time we were doing the intakes, he was just shaking his head, like, because some parts of Haiti are a lot worse than other parts. So where this kid was from that I know, he came from, like, a pretty decent part. But obviously where these kids came from, like, they had no education, no nothing. Half of them could not write. And it wasn't like they were little kids. So, yeah, I started tearing up. As soon as he said, like, as soon as my favorite, like, communicated to me, like, él no puede, like, he can't write his name. I was like, no, hombre, like, he can't write his name? And he was like, bitch. When I got my car, I'm so serious, bawled my whole entire car ride home. Like, I'm just really emotional, I guess, with this job, but, like, can you even imagine not being able to write your name at 17 years old? Like, it just puts a lot in perspective for you. Just crazy how some people really live. Like, he's lived 17 years and he's never had anyone to teach him to write his name. That's crazy. It's literally crazy. But okay. I just had to share that. Any fucking whore. So that was sad as fuck. So I was literally crying on my way home on my birthday. But it was more of like just an overwhelming, like, this is an experience that I'm glad that I got to experience because it's just another learning moment from God, period. So although it was emotional, at midnight, all the staff that was there, they sang happy birthday to me. And they, the one lady, she made a dessert. She's from Peru. And I had asked her earlier in the night, I was like, where's all your treats? Like, you usually bring treats. Like, every once in a while, she'll bring treats. I was like, you should bring some treats next week. But she had, and then she started smiling at the other lady. I'm like, what the fuck? What's so funny? But she had a treat for me, a dessert for everybody. And then she gave me this, essential oil. She, like, had it wrapped up in this little nice, like, thing. It was really nice. But it is lemon. And this brand I had never heard of, doTERRA. Let me know in the comments if you've had it before. Because the other supervisor, she was like, it's a really good brand, like, expensive. So I, like, googled it, shit. I'm like, why is she giving me something expensive? Ew. Of course I got it on my lip. It smells like literal straight fresh lemon. Like, what the fuck? But I do have an essential oil maker. Thank God, right? But I don't use it, like, on everything I love. It's been plugged into my wall for over a year now. Like, when I first moved in. And I've never. Like, I used it at my old apartment, but it's just a lot of work to, like, put water in it. And the drops. Fuck me. Oh my God, really? I was wondering who did the intake. I'm dead. Okay, guys, I'm so sorry. Speaking of that lady that just called me, I literally call her mama. She calls me her daughter. She got me this perfume. She wrapped it and everything. She said she got me this because she said I look like Katy Perry. I'm screaming. Katy Perry Indivisible. I don't think I look like Katy Perry whatsoever, but I literally heard that years ago. People used to say that. But this is how it looks. It smells pretty good. It's not something I think I would buy, like, on my own. But the bottle is, like, I think I'm gonna whisper. Yeah, I'm gonna whisper. Okay, so, yeah. Katy Perry's Indivisible. Why am I, like, not... I feel like I'm not pronouncing that right. But that was just so sweet of her. She brought this for me to work. She's so fucking funny. She's from Puerto Rico and she speaks English like that. Like she speaks English. This is her again, bro.
Hello? It's okay.
Oh my gosh. She calls me for everything at work, bro. I actually just said I would do something for her. That's like work related, but... Yeah. But that was super nice. It's kind of grandma-y, okay? I'm not gonna lie. It's kind of grandma-y. Thank you.
shift the night before that. I did a double, so I did 16 hours. And then I worked till like 1 in the morning, so I did a couple hours extra. So like 10 hours, but I just wanted to fucking chill on my birthday. Like, that's literally all I wanted to do. I bought myself a massage because I saw a sale online for some place near me, and I wish I didn't because my mom and my dad, they gave me a massage gift card, so now I have two massages. For this. that shit go. Like, but the thing about me is you are turning me off. Like, you're acting childish and it's turning me off. But you think that you're doing the opposite. You think that you're gonna make me pressed. Where's the logic, bro? Like, God bless. But anyway, this video, I'm gonna be so save maybe 45. If you're interested, the brand is Keystone. Keystone. So that's the ads. And okay, so then my best friend sent me a little gift box. Straw. she wasn't able to come. But yeah, it was nice. It was a really nice dinner. Like, that's just what I wanted to do for my dinner. Like, a really fancy dinner with some of my friends. That's it. That's all. Like, I'm not trying to do no extra shit. Like, I'm not trying to go to the club. No, I'm not. I'm literally off that shit. Like, it's fun every once in a while, but bitch, I gotta work the next day. My body don't function like that anymore. But one of the flowers, and then the girl from the retreat, she got me flowers too, so I combined them and I put them in a vase together. And I'm a flower girl, like, I love flowers. It's so crazy when girls are like, I hate flowers, I hate getting flowers, they're so beautiful. Thank you. sugar scrubs. They look like little cubes. That's kind of cool. It says champagne, shea butter, and aloe. And then this candle. Blush cashmere. And it is pink. Glad, okay, see, of course, that's what. It shows. happy birthday before. So it was just